The Philippine State Weather Bureau says while the El Nino phenomenon remains to be strong, it is showing signs of weakening. PAGASA says El Nino may return to neutral levels by April to June. The Bureau has also raised a La Nina watch, which is a period of excessive rainfall. Effects of La Nina, however, are not expected to be felt right away, so focus remains on mitigating the impact of El Nino. PAGASA notes the onset of the dry season may be declared in 2 weeks, with temperatures expected to surge as high as 38 degrees in northern Luzon. Going back to our top story, we're now joined by OFW Party List Representative Marisa Magsino to tell us more about government efforts to protect seafarers. Congresswoman, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Ron. How are you? How's everybody? I hope everything's fine, even with this very sudden news of our seafarers.
Right. Congresswoman, I did want to ask you about how you felt about this incident. Two Filipinos dead, two Filipinos severely injured. What's your reaction?
Ron, I'm very saddened about this news, and I'm sure the whole OFW and all our overseas Filipinos and all the Filipinos are so sad about this news. This is a very disappointing and very disgusting news because two Filipino seafarers were killed in this Houthi attack by the missile attack of this rebel group Houthi. And we are one with them. We condole with the family, and we would like to express our deep appreciation to our Department of Migrant Workers, to our President Bongbong Marcos for giving us the hand and the full support to be able to give assistance, repatriation if necessary already, immediate repatriation of the remains, and to be able to give a reintegration program to the families as well, Ron. Mm-hmm.
Congresswoman, the area where the attack happened, the Gulf of Aden, has already been designated as a high-risk area by a group of international maritime employers. Is Congress or are you going to be asking maybe the DMW to ask their counterparts why that specific ship, True Confidence, still had to take that route despite them knowing the risks and possibly endangering its crew, which included the Filipinos who were killed?
That's very true, Ron. I am so disappointed because this is already a high-risk location designated for our vessels, especially the Filipino seafarers and the Filipino crewmen that are always in danger of their lives, roting this very dangerous path. Vessel, this should be at least limited, and they should have a limitation on where the route should be going, especially for these vessels that are very important in the trade of the different countries. The DMW and two other Filipino crewmen that were severely injured in the attack, and the ship was ablaze around 550 nautical miles off the coast of Yemen's port of Aden. Wow, the agency, of course, even they found full support to the assistance of the family. We cannot discount the fact that maybe there is a lapse of judgment on this. I don't know who's the agency that is really responsible for this. Giving the route, it has to be limited once you know that it is a danger zone for our seafarers and the vessels as well, Ron.
Right. And I also read that seafarers had the right to decline pushing through, passing through that route if it was already designated as a high-risk area. It's either that if they push through, they will receive benefits or added pay, most especially if they are hurt, and their families will receive the benefits if they are killed. Would you be asking the DMW as well for an investigation if those crewmen did actually agree to push through going through that route?
Yes, definitely, Ron, because I will be asking them definitely, the DMW and maybe the other agency. I don't know if this will be having to do with some kind of the marina also, because they are everything about the seafarers. Then they will have to be answerable on this, because if Filipinos are coerced or the Filipino seafarers were forced to go on route, even though they did know that this is a dangerous path, then they have to be answerable to Congress and to the OFW party list as well, Ron.
Okay, Congresswoman, in your statement, you said that the risks those Filipino seafarers have shown the importance of passing that Magna Carta for Filipino seafarers. For if that was passed, it wasn't signed by Malacanang and it was withdrawn. I'm going to ask you more questions about that. But how could those seafarers benefited from that Magna Carta if it was passed?
Yes. The OFW party list is the principal author of the Magna Carta for seafarers. And of course, it wasn't signed yet by then President Bongbong Marcos because of some amendments that he would like us to add. And because of the passage very soon, we hope this will be passed very soon because it's now in the hands of Senate. We already had another arrangement for this, an amendment for this. We would like to say that the Magna Carta for seafarers is the reason. It is the most ultimate benefit that will have our Filipino seafarers be extended the necessary assistance, the necessary profit and benefits that they have to do, especially in a foreign vessel, and routing this dangerous route. Not only our Filipino seafarers, but the family as well. They will be insured, benefits, repatriation, insurance, medical, and everything that has to do with the Magna Carta for seafarers. And it is very clear in our Magna Carta that our prime reason for having this path is because we believe that our Filipino seafarers must be protected at all costs.
A clarification, Congresswoman, you did say that it is now in the hands of the Senate?
Mm-hmm. We already had it. We had a bicameral already with the Senate and the Congress. But then President Bongbong Marcos have some amendments to make and some arrangements that we also accepted. So we have to give it back to the Senate. Mm-hmm. And now after that, it has to go back again to Congress for finalization and then again to the hands of President Bongbong Marcos.
How long could that take for that whole process to be completed before it is passed by both houses and have have it sent to President Marcos?
I think this will not take too long, especially now that President Bongbong Marcos knows the very reason that this has to be passed immediately and no delay. I hope within this month of March or early April that will be happening, Ron. We hope so. We'll keep our fingers crossed.
Congresswoman Marisa Magsino of the OFW party list, thank you very much for talking to us.
Thank you so much, Ron. God bless us all.